Let's get going. We're not going to see so much door knocking in turn one. This time, there's only four cars. Olofsson has to kick the clutch twice off the line. Michaela Arlen-Kotlinski alongside in the background. Kyle Schwartz coming through. Tommy Howman going to shut the door on Schwartz. Arlen-Kotlinski slots in. Jared, three of these are going to get on the podium.
Yeah.
One is not. So Howman looking to try and get past Arlen-Kotlinski. But Olofsson, can he hold on for that dream win after a lot of carnage?
Oh, my gosh. Olofsson had one heck of a day yesterday, but now fights back. And speaking of fighting back, Michaela was going wheel to wheel, almost pitching out Olofsson, but he fought back. Hallman there in third and Schwartz in fourth. And like you said, just one barely outside watching and looking at that podium.
I'm impressed with Kyle Schwartz. Like I say, he's been in Scandinavia a couple of times recently on events I've been announcing. And to be fair, he's been learning. I watched an onboard of his from Finland, which he posted on social, and he's obviously feeling a little bit more comfortable in that car. But Jarrett, what he's making a lot of use of, what has done until just now, is following quicker drivers and seeing what they do. It's such a great way to learn, especially in a spec chassis. If they can do it, you can do it. And if you can't, then you need to go, what settings are they running, and try and dial it in. So Schwartz continuing that learning curve and doing a good job.
All right, so Olofsson, you saw at angle and then straightened it out on that Talladega turn. Michaela Arlen-Kotlinski sitting second, only 0.34 seconds behind.
Arlen-Kotlinski, very, very quick driver. Johan Kristoffersen's teammate in Extreme E for Rosberg X Racing, that took a win at the start of the season a long time ago now, it feels like, back in
January.
February. Yeah, it was a long time ago. We were supposed to have a round in Sardinia, but on the coast of Africa, but that's not happening for now. We've got a double header coming up with that. She'll be back in action with Johan. She obviously feels like she's quick, Jared, because she's jumped out of row and got herself back in. So Arlen-Kotlinski, look, is only... What is she now? She's dropped. Okay, the timing screen now updates. She's 1.1 behind Howman, so if she can hang on to that gap to Howman, she can hang on to P2 because he hasn't jokered yet.
Yeah, absolutely. That seems like the split that we've been seeing going into that joker lap. But Olofsson, like you said, this would be great redemption after a very tumultuous Saturday, but getting the win here on Sunday and had that such a dominant lead until the Hell in a Handbasket. Wheels went there, yeah. Jokers went there. Front ends and windshield wipers, carnage. So we are seeing Olofsson still out front, 1.2 seconds.
Howman, I think Howman will stay out, Jared. So basically, you got Olofsson 1.2 back to Howman. There's 1.4 look back to Arlen-Kotlinski. So Howman has edged a little bit over Arlen-Kotlinski. Now it's 1.7. So he will stay out. Bearing in mind, this is six laps. He'll stay out until he feels like he's got enough of a gap. He might then go, you know, before Olofsson, but if not, he'll hang on to the final lap if he thinks he's going to be the difference, obviously, between P2 and P3. Just trying to edge it up a little bit. Arlen-Kotlinski coming back by a tenth there.
Olofsson still out front. When is that joker lap going to be hit by Olofsson and Hallman? And that split between Michaela and Hallman still continues to be the same.
Yeah, that's the one that's absolutely key. Olofsson being a little more defensive now in terms of his lines. He's obviously starting to see yellow in his mirrors. That's what you want as the driver behind you. You make them drive on their mirrors. That's why you see in all forms of racing, people dipping out from the slipstream. Even when they don't have a chance to pass, it doesn't matter. It means the driver in front has a cheeky look in the mirror. They're not looking at the road in front. All the while you're making the drive on their mirrors, there's a chance they'll miss a braking point by just a tenth, and you can tear a couple of tenths out there, out of the gap. And he's right behind now.
Hallman is applying the pressure. Is Olofsson messing up? Or is Hallman just out driving him right now?
Hallman knows he needs to make a gap on Arlen-Kotlinski so that when he takes his joker, he can hold on to P2. But I tell you what, now he's got that gap, Jared, he's going to change his target. So this isn't now about hanging on to P2 as Hallman does the fastest lap of the race.
Oh,
this is about
man.
Trying to take the win. Look at the attitude in this car. We've got a lap to go. They're going to split the strategies, are they? They are. Olofsson goes this lap. Hallman's got one lap to try and take it off him.
Wow, I'm really surprised by that. I think, like you said, that technique of dummying him in there, I think Hallman was trying, or excuse me, Olofsson was trying to get Hallman there.
With him.
But no, Hallman's not today, Junior. Hold my drink. And so Hallman's going to continue on through the course. Olofsson in seconds. And Hallman tries to, look at 1.4 to 1.7. He's gaining more ground ahead. So it's going to come down to this joker lap. They're going to go uphill, drop down, and go into that joker.
Howman's done a brilliant job here. Arlen-Kotlinski's actually coming under a little bit of pressure in the background, but we're interested in this fight out front. Coming down the hill, so Howman to Joker. How late can he go on the brakes? Can he hold on to it? Watch here. He's going to go in as late as he dares. He's got to keep it tidy on the inside. It's a lovely entry, but on the inside line, Olofsson's going to have more speed as they come down to the line. Olofsson takes it at the flag.
Oh, look at that.
Tommy Howman slots into P2, just 0.4 of a second. What a great race between them. And Arlen Kotlinski just holds on from Kyle Schwartz. Schwartz was all over the back of Arlen Kotlinski. I wonder if there was a problem for Michaela because she dropped a long way back from Howman. Decent race considering half the contenders didn't turn up for the second
running. We started with eight, and guess what? Simon Olofsson, who was on his roof yesterday at the beginning of the day, ends the weekend by getting the victory. Congratulations. Simon Olofsson gets the victory. Tommy Hallman gets second, and Michaela Arlen Kotlinski unofficially gets third. Let's see if we get that graphic and celebrate here. And there it is. The flags are waving. The wind is blowing. And the victory is now the ownership of Simon Olofsson. Congratulations, Simon Olofsson, Tommy Hallman, and Michaela Arlen Kotlinski. 1, 2, and 3 at the first and second round of Nitro Rallycross.